Welcome to day 6 of the 21 day yoga challenge. And we're going to keep the routine joyful and playful with basics of balancing asanas. So today we'll be practicing the Vrikshasana or the tree pose in depth. And let's get doing multiple variations of this beautiful posture. Now, there is a common misconception that I would like to bust. Many people feel that doing complicated yogic postures or difficult looking asanas is what makes your workout effective. But let me assure you that the simplest of asanas, when done with the right alignment and awareness on each body part, can be amazingly therapeutic and have many beneficial healing effects. So let's start with today's practice. As I enjoy this gentle early morning sun. Bring your feet together in Tadasana. The legs are strong, the glutes slightly contracted. Shoulders are rolled back. And extend your arms out as you inhale and take it up in the Namaskarasana. Now interlock your fingers and ensure the palms are parallel to the mat and not curved. Extend the arms upward and feel the extension of the trunk. This is called the Badhyanguli Asana. Now turn your palms upward facing the ceiling. You can watch your palms to check if they're parallel and hold this for about 10 seconds. Exhale as you release your hands. Now gently close your eyes and take a few seconds to notice the blood flow in your arms. And again, on an inhalation, let's raise the hands up above the head and come up on your toes. Try to maintain your balance. Keep your gaze at a fixed point in front of you to maintain the steadiness. Keep extending up, lengthening the trunk. Keep pulling your arms upward and feel the extension in the length of your trunk. Now as you exhale, release your hands and come back on your heels. This forms your basic of balancing asanas and it really gets your feet activated to take the entire weight of your body. Now a few postures to teach our body to balance ourselves on a single leg. Again, standing in Tadasana. Lift your right leg up to 90 degrees. The standing leg is really active and is firmly pressed into the ground. Use your full foot to press into the mat. Now raise your arms up parallelly and hold this posture for about 10 seconds. Now to make the arms even more active, we raise it up to the ceiling, extend the trunk towards the ceiling. To further activate and stretch your arms, as you exhale, bring them behind your hips and interlock them. Stretch and pull back. So this must literally feel as if somebody is holding you by your arms and pulling you backward. So push back for a deep stretch, making sure that your right leg doesn't drop down. The angle needs to be maintained at 90 degrees. Turn your hand outward and push down. Hold this for about 5 seconds and release. We do the same with the other leg. So the left leg comes up. Bring your hands parallel to the ground and you hold this for about 10 seconds. Extending the arms upward and lengthening the trunk. Hold this for another 10 seconds. Exhale, bring your hands back and interlock them behind your hips. Pull back for a stretch in the arms. Hold this for another 10 seconds. Push down the hands by turning it outward and hold this for 5 seconds. Release and come back to Tadasana. Another posture for finding balance on one leg. Just extend the right leg backward by a foot. Hands wide open, parallel to the ground at shoulder level, and lift the leg off the ground and the hands back. And extend the head up. So this posture helps find balance on a single leg while opening up the arms and the chest. And come back to standing. Repeating the same on the other leg. Left leg goes back by a foot. Extend the arms out. And as you take a deep inhalation, fill up your lungs and stretch the legs back and the arms back, looking up at the sky. You can take it further back as much as you like, as much as your body permits you, and come back. So these were the preparatory postures to learn balancing the body on one leg, making the standing leg really, really strong. Now for a gentle twist in order to get the abdominals active. So again, bringing the leg up to 90 degrees, place the left palm on the right knee and the right hand comes up, extends sideward along the shoulder. For a further twist, look at the right palm. And when you turn your head, you tend to lose balance, which tells you the gaze really helps us find balance. And that your standing leg needs to be really strong. Keep the balance of the body. Release. We repeat the same on the other leg. So the left leg comes up, right palm on the left knee, left hand extended out, and the gaze at the left palm. And release. In case you feel dizzy after this posture, it's just because of the rotation of the neck and the vision. Do not panic, but just take some time to steady yourself. And now some prep postures to open up the hips. Again, bringing the leg up to 90 degrees, interlock your fingers, place it just below your knee and pull your knee towards your chest. Hold this for another 10 seconds. You could also attempt to touch your chin to the knee. Keep the standing leg straight and the knee is never bent. So always pull up the gaps and keep it tight. And release. We repeat this on the left leg. So left leg comes up to 90 degrees, interlock, place the hands around the knee and bring it up towards your chest. Touch the chin towards the knee. Standing leg always straight. The knee tends to bend slightly as you find balance, but bring your awareness to the leg to push it up straight and press it into the ground. Releasing, we stand straight in Tadasana. And now for another hip opener, bring your legs up to 90 degrees, place your palm on the knee and pull it out sidewards in the right plane, opening up the hip. Your left hand, the back of the palm can be placed on the hips to check if the hips are in line and they are not tilted this way. So if I were to show you this from the back, my left leg comes up to 90 degrees and I push it sideward. I'm making sure that my hips are in line and they are not tilted. And coming back. Once you know that your hips are aligned, for more balance, you can place your left hand on the hip. This helps you stay in the posture for a longer time. Similarly, on the other leg. And release. Now, having done all of this, our body is completely prepared and ready to do the Vrikshasana or the tree pose. So as many of you might know, the Vrikshasana or the tree pose looks like this. Now, in order to get into the posture, you could place the bent leg either on the ankle, slightly above the ankle or above the knee. The best would be to place it as close to your pelvis as possible. But never keep it on your knees, because this is going to knock your knees and damage it. So if you're a beginner, feel free to keep your feet on your calf, just above the ankle. But I will be demonstrating this posture by keeping my leg towards the pelvis. Another important point to note is that the toes should be pointing downward. They shouldn't be pointing obliquely in this direction or in the inward direction. With this, you tend to lose balance. Keeping these points in mind, you bring a leg up towards the pelvis. Now bringing your hands in prayer pose, extend it upward to Namaskarasana. This is your tree pose or Vrikshasana. Now a few points to keep your balance steady. Make sure that your right leg is in the right plane and it's not turned obliquely. Also, the right foot needs to keep pressing into the standing leg. Now, the more it presses, the pelvis opens up and becomes broader. It's facing the front. The more you push the bent leg into the standing leg turns to push down into the ground. And this helps you extend your trunk from the waist. So make sure you're not just keeping your hands up. That is, the extension is not coming just from your shoulders, but it's coming from the waist completely up. So this should feel like a single extension. And releasing. Now we practice the same on the left leg, and I will be showing you some variations of this beautiful posture. So bringing the left leg up to the pelvis. While the legs remain in this position, all the variations are going to come with your hands. So you can keep your hands wide out, parallel to the ground. Hold a mudra and look to one side. Now looking to your side can be slightly challenging with maintaining balance and comes with practice, but it's going to be a fun attempt. So do try it. Because like I mentioned earlier, the gaze is what helps us maintain the steadiness in the body. Then you can also bring your hands up to Namaskarasana on your head. From here, you can joyfully open up your palms and look at the sky. From here, you can bring your palms together in Badyanguliyasana. So the biceps are touching the ears and the hands interlock and the palms parallel to the ground, both facing downward and upward. You can also do the Vrikshasana with the hands in Paschima Namaskarasana. Shifting back to my right leg up. And bring your hands in prayer pose at the back. And extend the elbows out and sideward, almost making your shoulder blades touch each other. Roll the shoulders back and down. No exertion on the shoulder like this. If you're unable to do this, you can simply hold your elbows and change the interlock. And if this was easy for some of you guys, then you can keep moving your hands upward to make it slightly more challenging. And release. So I hope you enjoyed these fun variations of the Vrikshasana or the tree pose. This posture brings great steadiness of the mind. It helps with focus and concentration, makes the legs strong, it strengthens the back, extends the trunk, and also works on the arms. Because it's a brilliant pose for bringing concentration, awareness, and focus, it works as an amazing exercise for the kids. So make sure you have them try it out. Thank you very much and Namaste.